This sentence is important. 那么这个语句是很重要的。Confirm means be sure, be certain, 肯定。Experts were certain that a tumor will not attack a human being. 那么专家们肯定美洲狮是不会伤害人类的。If it is not cornered, 我用到了一个非常小小简单的词汇 if not, 解释了 unless。如果不是被逼入绝境，它是不会伤害人类的。那 we must grasp how to use unless. He will accept the job unless the salary is too low. Now, he will accept the job unless the salary is too low. 如果工资不是很低的话，他会接受这项工作的。所以说如果美洲狮不是被逼入绝境的话，它是不会伤害人类的。The search proved difficult, or the search proved to be difficult. 我们这里的 search, 在词汇当中已经给同学们讲到，它相当于 hunt, 为了避免重复出现同一词汇。那么这次猎捕行动证实很难。Why? For the tumor was often observed at one place in the morning,and at another place 20 miles away in the evening. 这美洲狮经常是在早晨出现在一个地方，而晚上又到了20英里以外的另外一个地方。So it was difficult for the experts to trail the tumor. 所以要跟踪这个美洲狮确实难度很大。Wherever it went, it left behind it a trail of dead deer and small animals like rabbits. 这里出现了三个 it. Wherever it went, it 指代 tumor. It left behind it 两个 it 均指代 tumor. No matter where it went, the tumor left a trail of dead deer and small animals like rabbits.Behind it. 那么同学们发现，把某物留在某后面 ，leave behind. 由于这里的宾语太长，一串串鹿或者是小动物，像兔子这类残骸，我们调制到了句尾，而把 behind it 调制到宾语之前来了。无论这个 tumor 走到哪里。他都会留下一串死鹿以及死兔子之类的小动物的痕迹。And of course, you must imitate the key structure. 这个优秀的句子结构也值得同学们模仿。这个伤员所到之处都留下了道道的血迹。那么我们应该怎么样表示呢？ Wherever he went, the wounded soldier left behind him.A trail of blood. Are you clear? Wherever he went, the wounded soldier left behind him a trail of blood. Okay. Paw prints were seen in a number of places, and puma fur was found clinging to bushes. 为了突出 paw prints 以及 puma fur, 所以我们采用了被动语态。在英文的表达方式当中，我们重点在于突出客观事实，而不像中文常常善于运用动作的执行者。 So it's not necessary for us to show who found puma paw prints. 我们没有必要去指明是谁发现了这个美洲狮的爪子印，所以采用了被动语态结构，一定要注意突出。Puma fur was found clinging to bushes. Clinging 现在分词，它强调正粘在了灌木丛上。 OK, now let's turn the sentence into active voice. 我们把这句话变成主动语态，增加一个主语 We found puma fur clinging to bushes. 现在分词做宾语补足语，表示正粘在这个灌木丛上。我们看到这个小女孩正缠着她的妈妈。We found the little girl clinging to her mother. 那么变成被动。大家发现这个女孩正缠着她妈妈。The girl was found clinging to her mother. 啊，动作用 think is easy. Several people complained of cat-like noises at night. 非常有意思，猫一般的叫声啊。Complain of, 抱怨 or complain about. A businessman on a fishing trip. On a fishing trip, 介词短语，修饰 businessman, 钓鱼途中的一位商人。那我们在运用介词 on 和名词搭配的时候，它是强调一个动作是正在进行的。For example, 在上升 on the rise, 在增加 on the increase, 在观看 on the watch, 在比赛当中 on the match, 那么在钓鱼的途中 on a fishing trip, 在度假 on holiday。这个商人看到了树上的也美洲狮。The experts were now fully convinced that the animal was a puma. Fully, 副词用来修饰 convinced means completely, entirely, 完全彻底的相信了。But where had it come from? 但是它来自于哪儿呢？ As no puma had been reported missing from any zoo in the country.This one must have been in the possession of a private collector. And means because. 因为没有美洲狮据报道从动物园里失踪。那么这个美洲狮肯定是属于私人收藏家所有了。In the possession of. 这是一个非常重要的介词短语。我们务必要把握住它和 in possession of 的区别。In the possession of somebody.相当于 in somebody's possession, 归某人所有 so we know possessed by somebody. 而 in possession of something, you know, 则表示拥有某物所以这是主动的概念。For example, 这辆漂亮的车是属于我的。The beautiful car is in my possession. The beautiful car is in the possession of me.反过来说我拥有这辆漂亮的车 I am in possession of the beautiful car 同时我们要把握住如何运用 take possession of 这是一个及物动词短语表示拥有那么大家要掌握动词短语和介词短语那么在应用的时候我们才表达起来得心应手拥有这大房子的人很是开心那显然我们是采用介词短语做定语比较方便The person in possession of the big house is excited and somehow managed to escape. 同学们发现不知怎么搞的竟然逃了出来。The hunt went on for several weeks. The hunt continued for several weeks. 持续了几周的时间。Or the hunt lasted for several weeks. But the puma was not caught. It is disturbing to thinkThat a dangerous wild animal is still at large in the quiet countryside. It sounds funny. Even though the puma will never attack human beings unless it is cornered, it is still disturbing to think that such a wild animal is free in the countryside. 虽然人们很清楚如果不是被逼入绝境美洲狮是不会伤害人的但是一想到这种野兽依旧逍遥在宁静的山村真令人担心啊 The last sentence is a wonderful phrase to imitate 最后一个语句结构也是值得同学们要模仿的地方 It 做形式主语而真正的主语是 that 所引导的从句那么这个句子结构也是为了保持句子的平衡It is disturbing to think that. Okay, are you clear? For example, it is disturbing to think that I fail my examination. 一想到我考试失败，就感到心里很不安。So, what make you disturbed? The failure of my examination. and this is the text. So you'd better recite the first paragraph after reading it over and over again. 给大家提供一个最好的建议，就是要在熟读完毕之后能够背诵第一自然段。And finish the exercise, vocabulary, and composition, special difficulties in multiple choice questions, particularly multiple choice questions. 好，我们再次回顾第一课所出现的系列短语，逍遥法外 ，at large， 认真对待 ，take something seriously。沾依偎于 cling to 留下 leave behind 抱怨 complain of 被什么所拥有 in the possession of 拥有拥有某物 of course in possession of 同学们已经体会到这里的区别那么同时我们要把握另外的几个小小的短语感到有必要进行调查 feel obliged to investigate 一个正在采黑莓的女士 a woman picking blackberries 钓鱼途中的商人 a businessman on a fishing trip next 持续了几周的时间 go on for several weeks 在宁静的乡村 in the quiet countryside OK so much for lesson one